a continuation of our trip here in Morocco. So this is actually the last long trip that I had before COVID, and I haven't uploaded it to my YouTube. It's just I get caught up with time. I got so busy with work since the last time we came back from that trip. So anyways, we had a trip here in Morocco for 2 weeks, so we're able to explore some very interesting places, and we're able to see the Berber village and also the astonishing scenery of the Atlas Mountains and the Dadis Gorge. So now we are heading there to Dadis Gorge. The traveling time takes roughly 2 hours to 3 hours, I believe. It's quite long, so if you will be on a tour or a package tour in Morocco for a couple of days, make sure that you are bringing your headset or entertainment with you, like phones, have your movies ready or some music that it's been saved on your phone. Or if anyways, yeah, because I was really bored in the car. The music, the driver kept playing the same thing over and over again, because in some areas there's no signal for his FM.
So that's the Jewish houses over there, but nobody lives there anymore because the Jewish already moved to Israel.
Pag ikaw, ipapag-ganon mo parate.
Portrait.
After the stopover, we continue our trip to the Atlas Mountain, and we are heading now to Tugda River, or the Tugda Gorge, or it's a canyon. This is a series of a limestone river canyons, or they call them wadi, in the eastern part of the high Atlas Mountains in Morocco. So this is near in the town called Tinghir. So after the stopover in the Jewish remnants or history area, we continue our trip all the way to the Atlas Mountains, and we had a stopover as well for lunch just before heading to the canyons. There's no other choices of the food except for the tajin, and thank God that there is chicken barbecue and rice that will do us, and also a bread and a water. So in this place, when you go on a tour, you can't really pick so many choices of food, so you have to be really game for whatever they have in there. Otherwise, you will be starving because there's not so much restaurants around the area, and the drive. And we don't know when is the next stop for food again, as we have to travel probably another 3 hours or 4 hours. It's just this trip, it's all about driving on the top of the Atlas Mountains and going round and round in circles, but it's really worth it. The view is just so amazing, and the feelings that you have while you're on the top, it's just surreal. It's just, I don't know how to explain it, but it's probably one of my most unforgettable trip in my whole life. I've been in so many travels. I'm probably traveling now for 10 years. But Morocco had a special place in my heart. It's just, this country is just so unique. I believe we are getting near now to Tugda Gorge. These are a series of limestone river canyons in the heart of the Atlas Mountains in Morocco. So this is near in the town Tinghir. The gorge or the canyons become top attractions for photographers, enthusiasts, climbers, and even the hikers. And also, the natural oasis created by the river, the Tugda, carving its way through the limestone for so many centuries. So this looks very prehistoric, with the canyon walls that reach over I believe it's 1,800 meters. Yeah, it's high. Walking on the fields here on the way to the Berber village.
It's visible, it's nice. It's the bird for animal. Here in this town, for the sheep wool, for donkey, for the camel. It's beautiful, it's nice.
Plenty of olive tree. I have olive tree here. There. More olives. We are visiting the Berber family. They're actually waving.
Aquila Familia Berberi. Familia Berberi.
It's very good wool to make carpets.
Okay.
And in Morocco. We import from China and from India.
Oh.
Yes.
Pizza. So now we are retiring on this hotel for today. It's quite a long drive from Merzouga to be here in Tangier. And yeah, the places that we went, it's quite a lot of drive. It's really far and I'm really tired and feeling sick. I think maybe because it's really freezing in the desert, my body is still adjusting.